Staros, by definition, a wooden stake driven in the ground used to cause torture or death. Staros, perhaps someone lied about the way that someone died.
The more stuff I write, and you write a lot of stuff, the closer I come to my own destination. What's your definition of your own destination?
I would say the complete oneness with the Spirit of God and knowledge of the truth. Larry and I have been, he's been so kind as to help me with a lot of things that I didn't quite have a firm grip on. There's a lot of temptation out in the world, and it can confuse you, get you wrapped up in something that keeps you from the truth, but loving brother like that by your side, usually you do all right.
So you are a loving brother, aren't you, Mr. Gray?
I try to be.
You always succeed in doing that, or?
Yeah, I feel so. We have a very close relationship. We spend a lot of time digging deep into the truth and deep into gaining more knowledge and drawing closer to our Creator, and that's very, very important. And then as a result, then you become closer to people around you that you love and that love you.
So working with the artist is more than just making music.
Oh yeah, it's we are connected heart to heart, and then out of the heart comes the music. That's the gift. But if we weren't connected heart to heart, then it would just be playing music with another musician, you know. And he's done that. I've done that. You know. Now is a special time in our life. We get a chance to play with people that we really, really, really care about deep inside. Yeah.
Can you always follow him in his very let's say specific ideas?
Well, he allows me freedom of thought, freedom of expression, you know.
So, why are you laughing?
Well, I'm actually smiling because it makes me happy, the thought, you know.
But for example, when the artist says, I celebrate the day I die, that's an idea you can follow completely?
Well, each day is a special gift from God, as he being the source of life. And yesterday is kind of like in the past. Yesterday did die, but we're looking forward to tomorrow, as he said a minute ago. We're always looking forward and not trying to look back. We can learn from things that we've done in the past, especially if we made some mistakes,
yeah.
And especially gain wisdom by applying the knowledge that we've gained in the past, and that'll help us to have a more successful future.
That's
so yeah, we're
all about.
Yeah, so we're always looking forward, not only with our spiritual life, but our family life, and also with our music. We're always looking straight ahead.
Once a person gets a firm grip of life and death, then they fully understand both. For example, you had how many birthdays?
Me? What do you think?
Well, I know that you had one birthday.
Yeah.
You were born
yeah.
on a certain day.
Absolutely.
You had no more birthdays after that. So I don't celebrate birthdays, so that stops me from counting days, which stops me from counting time, which allows me to still look the same as I did 2 years ago.
Flashbacks over the years. Are you the same man?
No, I don't think so. I'm constantly evolving, trying to work on my whole being to better myself and the world around me.
You're also a Jehovah's Witness now.
Yes.
How has that changed your life?
Oh, immensely. I started studying the Bible once I changed my name back, and started studying with my good friend Larry Graham. I used to play with Sly and the Family Stone, and he helped me to just look at the Bible in a very practical way, to cut through all the dogma and the thing that has kind of separated religion in the first place. I just wanted a clean, simple approach to it.
And it helps you with your music as well?
Well, definitely. I mean, it's going to help you with every aspect of your life. Once you can clean out the cobweb, so to speak, then you're going to see everything a little bit more clearly.
Thank you.
indeed an honor. Thank you so much. Awards are wonderful, but all praise and glory is due to the true God, Jehovah.
We're indentured servants, and we got a black president now.
Well, I don't vote. I have nothing to do with it. I got no dog in that race.
And for those who would cuss me out and slap me in person if I didn't ask you why.
Well, the reason why is because I'm one of Jehovah's Witnesses, and we've never voted. And that's not to say that I don't think President Obama is a very smart individual, and he seems like he means well. Prophecy is what we all have to go by now.
I was pretty wild in my younger days. And, you don't have to do what I did. You don't have to make any of the mistakes I made. The future's in your hands now. The world is really yours.